Hi there, I'm your neighbor. You will not see any scary pictures of bed bugs here to give you nightmares. Living with the bed bugs is a nightmare in itself. I'm just here to offer you tips which are working for me. Disclaimer, the tips I offer may or may not work for you. Please use your discretion and your own common sense. I'm just a resident of one of Toronto's buildings which is infested with bed bugs and cockroaches and whatnot. I first had a pesticide company come and do treatments, but the bugs were back in 2 weeks because they were in the building. So I decided to find a way myself. Here are the steps, and at the end of this article, I am listing out links to the products I use and their prices. Please check them out. Again, I'm not being paid for this. Steps: get a caulking gun and caulk tube and caulk every single hole you keep finding. Holes that shouldn't be there. Please Google to find instructions for caulking if you don't know how. Keep caulking. It's a process. Don't give up. Use OrthoMax insecticidal strips. The link is pasted below in the last section of the page of my website, bedbuginthebuilding.com. 3 to 5 per room. Use at least 3 to 5 per room. Close the bedroom off totally for 3 to 4 weeks. Sleep in another room or at a friend's place. Try not to breathe the OrthoMax, the insecticidal strip. If you have little children or respiratory problems, please do not use this. These strips are meant to be used in places where people are away for a long time, like cottages during winter. But I was desperate enough to use them in my home. Of course, I slept on the couch in the living room. So use gloves and mask. Please do not do this if you have children or pets. Halfway through, get a bed bug mattress and pillow coverings and put them on the mattress and pillows after making sure nothing is alive in the mattress. Do it after using OrthoMax strips and getting rid of the bugs in the room. Under each leg of the bed, put bed bug discovery trays. In the tray, puff some diatomaceous earth. This is crucial for a good night's sleep. Once sure that nothing is alive, you can air out the room. Remember to air out your place now and then to avoid building up of the toxins. Use a table fan to air out the room to get the carbon dioxide out of the room. Keep the window or door open while you do that. The bugs are attracted to carbon dioxide. Close vents and exhaust with 2 layers of fabric softener sheets. Use thin layer of caulk at the edge to put 2 sheets together if the exhaust is big. And affix the sides to the vents with silver foil tape from Canadian Tire or Home Hardware. You can dust and vacuum the sheets lightly or replace them every few months. Once a week, sprinkle a thin layer of diatomaceous earth on the floor across the walls, lining all edges of the walls of the whole apartment. Buy a wire rack and put your immediate, everyday, regular clothes on it. The rest of the clothes should be in clear, big plastic bags from No Frills or any other grocery store. Remember to tie them up each time after you take something out. Try to reduce as much stuff you have. Throw things out that are not necessary. Gather all your willpower. You can do it. Be very firm with yourself. Bug-proof the shower drain. Buy borax. It also repels bugs. Put a stopper in the drain in the bathtub. Leave some water in the bathtub, sprinkle borax onto the drain where the stopper is. This acts similar to a drain trap, ensuring that the bugs do not come from the drain. Do this after each shower. You can find borax in the laundry aisle of your grocery store. Extreme measures: bug-proof the shower tap if you have to. Affix a latex glove to the tap of the bathtub and then tie it up with a rubber band or hair tie to prevent any bugs from entering through the tap. Seal off the water valve compartment under the bathroom sink with foil tape. Be very vigilant. Any tiny round red or black spot you see, if it is moving or not, crush it with a tissue. You will find that they have a distinct smell. If you are having periods, please buy an airtight container with a screw top lid and put your used sanitary pads in a plastic bag. Keep tying the bag up before you put the bag in the container. Remember, the sanitary pads with blood will attract them. All the best. On a personal note, please keep praying and asking God or universe or higher power to help you. Even Even after doing all of the above, I still keep finding them now and then, especially in the bathroom, as the building walls, the drain areas between the walls of the building, have the bugs, and they come from other units into the building, into my apartment. So building managements blame it on the residents, but the bugs reside in the walls and drains. How are the residents supposed to stop them? Anything you are not going to be using, seal them up in big, thick, heavy-duty garbage bags from No Frills and put an Orthomax strip in it and seal it well. Leave it for 2 weeks and whatever bugs are there will die away. And you can then be sure that things are free of bugs. You can do it to books and clothes. Seal off any electric outlet you are not using with a plate cover. Caulk around the edges of the plates, open or closed. You're not allowed to do this, actually, in case the building wants to access it. But, you know, desperate times. If you want to be extra cautious, cut thin pieces of the Orthomax. Use gloves and mask. Please do not do this if you have children or pets. Unscrew the outlet plates and carefully insert a piece in the outlet in the crevice near the wall, not the electrical part. Be careful. When you are doing this, switch off the power to the house. And then you screw the plate back again, turn on the power back again. Keep using diatomaceous earth around the edges of the walls consistently. They usually travel through the edges, though some strays dare to crawl across the rooms. The diatomaceous earth is fossilized powder. Don't breathe too much in. It is not good for the lungs. Same stands for Orthomax strips. Wear a mask when spraying it, follow instructions on the box, and let the powder settle before using the room again. You can leave the Orthomax strips in the washroom and other areas. In the bedroom, leave one in the closet. Keep doors closed, the closet doors closed. Do not depend solely on one product, as the bugs get immune to the Orthomax strips or Raid or whatever that you are using. They can get immune to that quickly. The strips last for 3 to 4 months and then you'll have to replace them. And they are not a sure thing, you know, it can help. If you want to save money, wear a mask, use gloves, then pry open the Orthomax cage and cut the strips into halves or quarters and use them in different places of the rooms. They're hard to cut, so be careful about your fingers. Each day before going to sleep, check the sheets and pillows for anything suspicious. Wash the sheets frequently in hot water and dry them in a dryer once every 2 weeks at least. If you happen to have a box spring for your bed, then get Mover's plastic bed mattress bag from U-Haul. Put the box spring in it. Be careful to tape up all the rips in the bag. They can be flimsy. Seal the bag well on the box spring with clear packing tape. And finally, tell those buggers to get the heck out of there. It's your place, not theirs. I'm not getting any commission for posting the links on my website, just naming the products I have used consistently over the years. Prices noted here are approximate values, may change over time, and all stores are in Canada are from Canadian websites. Like I've used some from Canadian Tire, from which I have bought the caulking tubes and the caulking guns and the Ortho Home Defense Max No Pest Insecticide Strip and the Chem-Free Insectagon Bed Bug and Flea Killer and the Cantec Foil Tape, the Bath Stopper, and from Amazon.ca I've got the Waterproof Mattress, the Bed Bug Mattress Cover, and the Pillow Cover, and the Bed Bug Traps, which don't work. That's why I use the diatomaceous earth in it so that nothing crawls up the bed. So I also bought a wide mouth jar with pressurized seal. It's a free crystal clear PET. And I got a wall plate to seal off some of the outlets I'm not using to keep my clothes in, actually. A wire rack is good. And the garbage bags, I got them from No Frills, and fabric softener sheets from No Frills, and the borax from No Frills, and the mattress bags, which go on the box spring, from U-Haul. So I hope you found this helpful. I sincerely hope that no one should have to deal with this bed bug problem. The whole of Toronto is infested, and the building managements are just busy making money and blaming it on the residents. And it's really hard. They are just charging money, maintenance and rent, but not doing much to help us. So I hope some action will be taken in the future. People will rise up and petition or talk to the mayor or the building managements. I hope something gets done to help relieve this problem. My heart goes out to all these people and to myself, who I am in this situation. And I know many, many people who live in my building are in this situation and are just tolerating the problem, bearing it. So this is a form of torture. So please, if you have any influence to do something, please do it. Help us. Thank you very much. Thank you for watching my video.